Hello, everyone, and welcome to Prophecy Files Briefing. We're glad that you've joined us today, and I want you to be sure to stay tuned. At the close of this briefing, I want to give you some important information about the upcoming Prophecy Files Conference right here at Pace Assembly that you will not want to miss. We're only just a few weeks away, and I can assure you the information you'll hear is going to be vital for your future. But first, I want to take you to a couple of articles that I think are extremely important in light of the return of the Lord Jesus Christ and the evidence of the spirit of Antichrist that is swirling and the anti-word of God attacks that are taking place. This article deals with the truth of the Bible is on trial in Finland. One of the government officials there, simply by quoting the passage of scripture from Romans chapter 1, has now come under being literally filed and taken to court now for a second time, simply because that she posted the scripture from Romans 1. And it was directly, of course, against what the LGBT advocates were saying. In this particular article, it is against the law to be able to speak that way in Finland. And the problem becomes is, and this is what her statement is, she said, if I would be convicted, it would have consequences around Europe because the LGBT advocates, they are so active and aggressive, she said, and they have very strong networks, so it would have effects in other European countries. We're seeing that take place even in the United States, where the Word of God is now in some ways being described as hate speech. But I want you to know that with all that is taking place with that, the Word of God is going to be forever and true. It is forever settled in heaven. What God calls sin is still sin. But where there is a vacuum of the voice of God or hearing the word of the Lord, you get other things to fill that. And this, you've heard me talk about AI and the AI Jesus, where people are now able to type in their question or text their question and get a response back from Jesus. Well, this particular article, or at least I should say, artificial intelligence Jesus that is described. This article, Holy Chat, it says, AI Jesus now offering advice through texting. The article reads, and this is very important because with all of the cancel culture that's happened in our world in recent years, this is an attempt to cancel belief and faith in Jesus Christ. This new software program is offering people the opportunity, it says in this article, to text Jesus and get a response. A report from the Religious News describes the new program that is like an instant messaging platform that lets users chat with ChatGPT impersonators. Text with Jesus was launched just a few weeks ago and comes from what's called Catloaf software of Los Angeles. Very important that you know that this is an attempt as well, of course, to undermine and to take people's faith away from the true and the living God and the true and living Word. The chief of this particular software said, we stir the AI and tell it you are Jesus or you are Moses or whoever. And knowing what you already have in your database, you respond to the question based on their characters. The article goes on to say that this report explains that chat with Satan is also active if the user chooses. One of the leaders in this software said that they've invited church leaders to try the program and see how it's being developed and then draw their concerns or ask questions. And one of them is that it lacks Bible reference. It goes on to say, and this is very important in this article, this inventor said he made some adjustments so, quote, it can speak more like a regular person. Of course, it's a computer program and acts like one, the article says. But Peter, one of the instigators of the software, said that he set it up so Jesus characters tend to avoid making offensive stances. Instead, they take an inclusive or tolerant line. Even though the Bible documents Jesus being absolute regarding salvation, one of the ideas out of this software comes, and when a person is asked about same-sex marriage that is forbidden in the Bible, the creation or the creator of this particular software says that it it is up to each individual. This is the response. It's up to each individual to seek guidance from their own faith and tradition and personal convictions. My friends, what we're watching is exactly what Jesus said in Matthew 24. And here's the scripture. Matthew 24, verse 10. And then shall many be offended and shall betray one another and shall hate one another. And many, listen to this, false prophets shall rise. Now, sometimes we want to declare that to be some preacher behind a pulpit, but what you're looking at is false prophecies and false prophets trying to deceive, the Bible says, and shall deceive many. And because iniquity shall abound, or sin in the heart and life of individuals, the love of many shall wax cold. In other words, the desire for truth and the fading and apostasy would take place. These are last day signs. And verse 13, but he that shall endure to the end, the same shall be saved. That's the promise for the believer. Listen to Matthew 24, verse 23. Then if any man shall say unto you, lo, here is Christ or there, and it really stood out to me, believe it not. Believe it not. Interesting. For there shall arise false Christ and false prophets, and shall show great signs and wonders, insomuch, if it were possible, that shall deceive the very elect. Could it be that people are being deceived by these particular chat devices and all that's taking place, or it is the precursor to a massive deception that is on the horizon? The Bible tells us very clearly, don't follow after that. So in our closing here today, let me help you identify false prophets by their message in this five question test, so to speak, that can help you. First, what is the source that this individual or AI is speaking from? Is it the Bible that is basing, where they're basing their teachings on? Check out the Savior test. Do they believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God? Here's the third test, the subject test. Is the primary focus of that teaching the gospel of Jesus Christ? Here's the salvation test. Do they teach salvation by grace alone, through the cross alone, by faith alone? These are tests. And here's the fifth and final one, the sanctification test. That is, does the individual, the false prophet or the false messaging, false texting, false software, does it teach and endeavor and direct people to holy living towards Christ? This is just a few questions that you can ask to help you be able to identify the faults and the deception that is taking place in our day. And it is massive. I want to encourage you to stay with the truth. Jesus said, I am the truth. And that truth has the power to make you free. I encourage you today to stay with the Word of God. And if you don't have a Bible, just contact us. We'll be glad to send you one back. I also want to let you know that by the time that you read and study the Word of God and see what's taking place in our world, I believe that you'll agree with me that Jesus Christ is coming soon. Well, this is Pastor Joey Rogers, and I want to give you a special invitation to join me for the upcoming Prophecy Files Conference. This Bible prophecy conference is going to be filled with information concerning the end times and how you can be prepared for the imminent return of Jesus Christ. This year, I'll welcome my special guest, Jeff Kinley, Pastor Shane Warren, William Federer, and keynote speaker, Pastor John Hagee. I want you to join me for this year's Prophecy Files Conference. Registration is available online at paceassembly.org, and lunch will be provided for a cost of $10. We look forward to seeing you right here at Pace Assembly on September the 16th and 17th for this year's Prophecy Files Conference.